Welcome everyone to the 2020 APEC Groundbreakers Virtual Tour by APACO-UC. This year, our event will be the biggest one ever done, with 174 sessions, including normal sessions, workshops, and hands-on labs from 123 different speakers over 11 days. Also, it will cover sessions on four different languages. Please remember to register to as many sessions you can, and all sessions will be available to replace as many times as you want for 2 weeks after the initial session date and time. You can also interact with the speaker at any time during the two weeks after his session by posting questions or comments directly in the playback session page. I would like to say thank you to all Oracle user groups and Java user groups that made this event possible, and also to our sponsors, Oracle Groundbreakers and CloudDB. Now today's session, Reactive RDBMS Accessing using Reactor, RX, Java, Akai Streams, and R2DBC by Kwasi Mensah from Oracle Corporation. Please feel free to write any questions after the session in the page of the session, and Kwasi will be more than happy to respond. Now, without any more delays, I would like to leave you with this amazing session by Kwasi Mensah, and please enjoy your conference.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to my session. Let me share my screen. Okay, so this session is about reactive relational database access using Reactor, RX, Java, Akka Streams, and R2DBC. My name is Kwasi Mensah. I work for Oracle. You can follow me on Twitter. I also publish blogs on Medium. Here is our disclaimer. I'll be talking about things not yet available, so that's our legal disclaimer. So who am I? I do product management for Oracle. I take care of the database access for Java. So anything Java that needs to talk to the database, including Java, JVM languages such as Scala, Kotlin, Clojure, etc., Groovy, and all the modern programming models such as serverless functions, all the Java application containers such as Tomcat, JBoss, WebSphere, etc., the Docker container, all the frameworks, etc., etc. So I also take care of the embedded JVM in the database and the high availability, the multi-tenant sharding, and also turning Oracle tables into Hadoop data sources. And as I say, you can follow me on Twitter. So this is the agenda. I'm gonna discuss what are reactive streams, what are the Oracle JDBC reactive extensions, which are coming in the next release. And then I'll go through RDBMS access using Reactor, R2DBC, RX, Java, and Akka Stream. Those are all third-party or reactive streams libraries or API. So when we talk about reactive streams, I can single lights, three or four things. Anyway, it is not really an API that you can use directly. It's a service provider interface for achieving asynchronous data streams with back pressure. So what does back pressure mean? It means between the publisher and the subscriber. So those are the two entities. Producing streams, the publisher is publishing streams and the subscriber is consuming the stream. So between the two, They need to synchronize so that the publisher does not push too much data, more than the subscriber can swallow. So that's why you need a control flow, a flow control mechanism. Usually it's a Java object called a subscription, and that Java object defines two methods, the request and the cancel. So the subscriber can say, okay, give me 10 or give me 20, and then the publisher will send 20. So reactive streams is asynchronous data streaming with back pressure, okay? And then here are the Java Flow API to implement reactive streams. There is no implementation of the reactive stream in Java SE. You have an interface, you have a publisher interface, which has one method, subscribe, and the subscriber interface, which has those methods. So you have to implement yourself, or the driver or the framework will implement this, and those are under the cover. So in real life, nobody code directly with those API or those SPI. Okay, so what are the reactive extension in JDBC driver? In the Oracle Database 21c release, which will come any time now, the driver, you know, when you get the driver jar, it includes the extension to support reactive database access. And this is based on Java util concurrent flow. The flow API was what I talked in the previous slide, which has two interfaces, the publisher interface and the subscriber interface with the method that I have shown in the previous slide. So the Java user code will just call a subscription request to get a connection. And from that, you know, the reactive streaming will happen. The implementation uses the NIO selector for people who are familiar. So the result of that is no thread will block waiting on the database. So it's always asynchronous. The extension is a minimal API. It's not a complete set. It's, you know, it's not like complete substitution to the traditional synchronous JDBC API, but it has what is sufficient to build a Java application doing using reactive streaming. But once again, as I said, we are not expecting people to use those extensions directly, but it is possible. You can do it, but we expect people to use those through reactive streams libraries. And it will be clear when I go further in the presentation. So the method have a suffix Oracle to avoid name conflicts in the unlikely events that the Java community decided to make something like that a standard, a JDBC standard. So we anticipate that could happen. We don't know, but we say, if it happens, well, we're gonna prefix our method with Oracle so that there is no conflict. And here are the extensions that I'm talking about. You can see here, you get a connection, a publisher connection. There is a build connection publisher method as well. So here you can see all the JDBC methods, the traditional JDBC methods, such as execute, execute update, execute batch, execute query, et cetera, followed by async and Oracle. So execute async Oracle will do what execute do, you know, a statement execute what it does, but it will do it in an asynchronous fashion. And we put Oracle to avoid conflict if JDBC standard body in the future decides to have an execute async. Okay, so those are the equivalent of the corresponding JDBC. And you can see execute batch, execute query. This is to retrieve the result set. Here you're dealing with a blob, and here you are dealing with clubs, okay? Well, I'm not gonna go into the details of the API. If you're interested, when the release is out, you can look at that. And then to finish, you have the commit async Oracle, rollback async Oracle, and close async Oracle to close the connection. Okay, so that's the reactive extension. And the subtitle of the slide says it exposes standard publisher subscriber types. Those are those types, that can interoperate with Reactor, R2DBC, RxJava, and Akka, which are higher level frameworks that people use to do reactive programming, right? So, and this is the big picture of everything you will be able to do with JDBC when the 21C release goes out. So you are familiar with the traditional Oracle JDBC drivers, and those are used to do synchronous blocking calls. So you make a call to the database, and you have to wait. The call will block until database returns. With the reactive extension, you can now do async calls with non-blocking back pressure. Okay, implementing the Java util concurrent flow API. Okay, so the driver implements that. We do implement the Java util concurrent flow. So we sort of avoid that the end user will be doing that implementation. And then the extension can be used by third party reactive streams on the R2DBC API, which is now being adopted by all vendors. And this is an announcement. Oracle will be releasing an Oracle R2DBC driver in a shorter term. It's gonna be open source. So what we're saying is that those reactive streams libraries, they have higher level operators, you know, way of doing things. You know, you can do map, you can reduce, you can filter, you can have concurrency modeling, monitoring, tracing, etc. So that people familiar with reactive streams know what I'm talking about. Okay, now let's look at concrete example of doing reactive RDBMS access using the Reactor framework. Okay, so how does this integrate with the reactive extension? Okay, so from the bottom to the top, here is the reactive extension, JDBC reactive extension, right? As I just showed in the previous slide. Then, so the reactive extension, JDBC reactive extension, it produces Java util concurrent flow types. But all the reactive streams libraries, they use org reactive streams types. So the reactive manifesto body was created a long time ago, and they have defined the org reactive stream types long before Java SE came with the Java util concurrent flow. So the flow types here are not identical to the org reactive stream types. You know, you can map, but it's not the same thing. So you need to do some conversion. And then we provide this class, JDBC reactive adapter class, to do the conversion. I'll show you the code in a moment. And then once you have that in place and you've done the conversion, well, if you want to build an application using Reactor, then you need to have a Reactor data access object class. In the example that we're gonna see, we will execute a SQL statement to recoup rows from a table, and we're gonna produce a flux data streams out of that, and then the application will do something about it. You know, it's gonna, so this is the real application which will be doing map, filter, reduce, blah, 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 on top of the stream that's returned by the Reactor data access object class, okay? So it looks like this. This is the application. So you can see here, we are getting the sum of the purpose of the application is to return the sum of all salaries, okay? And then we are streaming all employees. I'll show you the code of stream all employees. So we get a streams of employee objects. And on that we're gonna implement some map function, filter, etc., etc. I'll explain a little bit later. So that's sort of the substance of the application. So time for a demo. This will be a live demo. Okay. Okay, so this is my IntelliJ. Let me go in presentation mode and I'll start with this one, employee ORM. So let me go into presentation mode so you can see clearly what I'm talking about. You see here, so the purpose of this class is just to do some object relational mapping. So in fact, we're mapping every column of the table, the employee, the e-name, the commission, blah, blah, blah. This is from the HR schema. If you're familiar with Oracle database, we have an HR schema and the employee table of the HR schema has those columns, you know, employee name, blah, 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 hire date, job, department number, salary, etc. So this class is just doing the mapping. So at the end, we're gonna produce an employee object. So we're using the build pattern here. So when we build this, we're gonna produce an employee object. So that's what we're gonna use when we're doing the reactive stream. We're not gonna use straight resources from the database. We're gonna be using the employee object. Okay, so that's for the ORM, exit presentation mode. Okay, so we are here. Okay, now let me show you the adapter class, which maps flow types to org reactive stream types. Once again, go into presentation mode, okay, here we go. Okay, so you can, like this one. Now let me see, exit presentation mode. What I want to show is reactive adapter. Yes, I think that's the one I want to show. Yes, that's the one I want to show. Okay, so we're good. Presentation mode, okay. So you can see that we have the reactive streams types, you know, flow adapters, publishers, subscription, all those are from the reactive stream types. And then we have the org reactive adapter class, which is an Oracle provided class to map from the flow types to the org reactive stream type. So you can see here we have publisher connection, which will use the connection builder that we have, and then we'll build the connection and then we'll return a flow publisher. No, it's gonna, yeah, it return a flow publisher. Okay, it return a flow adapter, right? Flow adapter to publisher class, okay? And same thing for publish query, you can see it return a flow adapter to publisher, a query publisher. It takes a flow publisher Oracle query publisher as the result set and produces a flow adapters to publisher. So same thing for all the other method. You can see here the publish rows, it's gonna take a result set, will unwrap, will publish an Oracle, a publisher Oracle, okay? And then it's gonna return a flow adapters to publisher. So essentially what this class does is furnish method to do the mapping, to map between the flow types and the org reactive stream types. Okay, I hope this is clear. Okay, so next I need to show you the DAO. So this demo is about Reactor. Later on, I'll show you the R2DBC demo as well. But for now, let me show you the DAO, the data access object, employee data access object, if I'm using Reactor. Okay, we put reactive extension because we don't believe anybody will use the extension as is. So this demo is using the reactive extension with the reactor. Okay, sorry if you can see me, I'm sweating. It's so hot in San Francisco today and I don't have air conditioning. So what is the adapter? What is this DAO is doing? This DAO has two methods. So you can see here, it has the stream all employees, that's method. So that's method, we have a flux using when. So this flux using when is needed to close the connection. Now we're gonna get a connection. You know, you see here, we publish a connection here. So we need to close the connection, and this is the method to control that when the stream is over, excuse me, when the stream is complete, we will close the connection. So this creates a mono which emits one connection. This called mono from blah, 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 okay? A mono is a type in reactor which produces one element. It's a string type. It has zero or one element. Whereas a flux is also a streaming type from reactor which has multiple elements. So when you have a stream of objects, you have a flux, but if you only have one element, like a connection or a result set, you use a mono type. So here, the connection used to create a flux of employees. You see here, we query all employees through the connection, and then we close the connection. And this is the query all employees class. You can see what it does. It takes a connection as an argument. And this also is important to close the prepared statement when we're done with the string. When the string is done, we close. So what it does, it has a prepared statement. Okay. It's use a prepared statement. Okay, it's gonna execute the prepared statement and then recoup the result set. So this will produce a mono, which is a result set, right? So from the result set, we're gonna use a flap map to produce a stream. It's gonna emit multiple rows. So how can I equalize? This is, okay, thank you. Okay, so this will emit multiple rows. And then here we map each row to an employee object. Remember the employee ORM I showed you at the beginning, which maps the database column SQL types from the result set to a POJO. So the employee object is a POJO. Okay, so that's what it does. It queries all employees and returns streams of employee objects. Okay, now we're gonna build the application on top of that. So let me exit presentation mode once again here. Okay, so come back here. And now we're gonna look at the application. So this application is using Reactor, and we are using the extension for the Reactor. Okay, so let me go into presentation mode again. Okay, so this application, it's gonna get some of all salaries. That's what it does, and it produces a mono, which is sort of the integer, which is the sum of the salaries, right? Okay, so first of all, we get a reactive extension DAO. Remember the DAO, which is the data access object, which produces streams of employees. So streams, all employees, we're gonna get a flux of employees. So it's streams of multiple employees. Okay, from there, we're gonna map only to the column. We only need the column, the salary column. So we do a mapping to the salary, the get salary in the POJO object, recoup only the salary. And then we filter to make sure we filter out employees without salary. We only want employees which has a salary. Then we get the salary, and we do a reduction by doing a summation. So it's a sum of all the salary. Then we're gonna return. We're gonna return the salaries. And then we're gonna wait till the processing is done. And then we print out the result. Okay, so now if I exit presentation mode and I execute, let me execute this application. So this is live connecting to my database. So if everything goes well, it should just print a result, you know, the value, which is the sum of all the salaries of all employees, okay? So that's the reactor. Now, R2DBC. So what is R2DBC? R2DBC stands for Reactive Relational Database Connectivity. And it is something coming from, what is the name of the company now? I forgot. Having a hole in my memory. Anyway, if you go to this site, this is the site where the R2DBC IO, where you can see the specification, et cetera, et cetera. Okay. So it's based on the reactive switch specification. Okay, it provides a full reactive non-blocking API. It works with relational database, hence the name Reactive Relational Database Connectivity. Okay, in contrast with JDBC, it's using a reactive API, supports scalable solution, blah, blah, blah. Okay, so that's R2DBC, and vendors are now building drivers, the R2DBC drivers. And as I said, Oracle will have an R2DBC driver sometime in the near future. Okay, so this is it again. And here, the R2DBC also uses org reactive stream types. And similar to reactor, it also have a mono stream of 0 or 1 element and flux stream, multiple elements. Okay, so we have the extension, the JDBC extension. We have the adapter class. So the difference with what I showed you before is that in the driver, we already incorporate the adapter class. So when you get the R2DBC driver, it already have the adapter class to do the conversion. So all you have to do is build your R2DBC DAO class, data access object class, to execute the SQL statement and return the flux data stream, and then build your application on top of the streams, right? So it looks similar to reactor. In fact, R2DBC is based on reactor, you know, the founder, the same company promotes reactor. Okay. And this is the application, and you can see it's almost identical to the reactor application. It's the same thing, and it's not a surprise. So let me go into IntelliJ. And so here I'll show you the employee DAO object. Everything else is similar. So the ORM is similar. And the DAO, if I go to presentation mode, Okay, so R2DBC DAO, okay, and you can see that we are constructing employee DAO. So this is a connection factory, and we are putting all the information to connect to the database. So don't look at this because this is my database. And then we have, we are streaming all employees, producing a flux. You see the same syntax using when. And so we get a connection object. We create a statement, we execute the statement. We produces a result set, and we, from the result set, we produces a string of employee objects. Okay, that's what this code does. Okay, now let's look at the application itself. And it should be identical or quasi-identical to the reactor approach. So this is the application itself. And if I go into presentation mode, so you can see here, it get an instance of employee DAO, get instance, stream all employees, map employees to get the salary columns of the employee object. It filters out employees without salary, so we only want employees with salaries. And then we map, we get the salary column, and then we summarize, we do the summation. So we do a summing to only output the sum of the salaries, okay? So it's a quasi identical to reactor, and not surprise. Okay, so let me execute, and if everything goes well, it should produce the same result. I don't know if anybody remembers what was produced before, but it should be the same. Okay, so this is the same, exactly. Okay, and this is live, you know, connecting directly to my database. So let me go back to the presentation. Okay, so that was the demonstration of R2DBC. Now RxJava. RxJava is also another reactive stream library, different from Reactor. And similarly, it deals with reactive stream types. Now, instead of mono and flux, it has what is called flowable streams. Flowable, and it's similar to flux, for example. And so here you have to do the same step, like from the extension, we need an adapter class, and then we do the RxJava DAO, Data Access Object class, and then we have the application, and you can see map filter, reduce, blocking, get. So it's sort of similar to what you would do with Reactor or the other. So you can see that it looks very identical, right? It's only the finishing part, you know, this which is different. Instead of block, it's blocking get. Okay, so that's almost RxJava. The last one is Akka Streams. So Akka Streams, the Akka people are one of the founder of the org Reactive Streams, so they know very well what this is about. So Akka Streams also deals with org Reactive Stream types. And here, instead of flux or mono or flowable, it's source. So they produce a source stream. And here, the same technique from the reactive extension, we need the adapter class. And from the adapter class, you can now build a DAO, a custom data access object class. And you can see how they're doing the thing. So one thing I need to mention here is that Akka Streams still uses a lot of methods from completable future. You can see here, they do borrow a lot from the completable future, okay, unlike the others. So anyway, that's a small differences between the Reactive Streams Library framework. And this is the application. You can see here, in an instance, stream as employee, and to materialize, we get map the salary, filter out, map to get the salary, and then this is sort of the way to do the summation, okay? And then here is you can see the completable future, then accept, and the completable future, and then train once everything is done, and then the result. So, yeah, that's pretty much what I have. And I hope it gives you an idea of what reactive streams are, what the Oracle JDBC reactive extensions are, what R2DBC is, and how you can use the third party reactive streams libraries to do reactive database access. I don't have too much time, otherwise we could go into more advanced example, doing the parallel or things like that, using more advanced operators from the third party library. So yeah, that's pretty much it. So thank you very much. And I think I'll see you on the Q&A. So thank you. I'll stop sharing and end the call.